Some stocks truly do not know when to quit. Just look at Square, symbol SQ. It's the payment technology company. I'm going to emphasize technology in that sentence, with devices that make it easy for anyone with a smartphone to take credit card payments. In addition to their point-of-sale hardware and software, the company has a bunch of other businesses, like a lending arm, Square Capital, a cashless payment system, Square Cash, and even their own restaurant delivery platform, Caviar, which we use at Bar San Miguel. Ever since its IPO nearly 2 years ago, this stock has been on fire. In fact, just since the beginning of 2017, Square's stock has effectively tripled, and it just keeps getting better. Last week, the company reported a fabulous quarter, great acceleration, 45% adjusted revenue growth. Then today, the stock surged on news that Square started testing ways to let users buy and sell Bitcoin on their platform. What do we need to learn about that? While the share price gave up most of their gains as part of the broader pullback, I think this already positive story has suddenly gotten even more intriguing. So let's dig deeper with Sarah Friar. She's Square's chief financial officer. Hear more about the quarter and this new Bitcoin initiative. Ms. Friar, welcome to Mad Money. Good to see you, Sarah. Have a seat.
Great Thank to see you. Thanks for having me.
All right, so I am struggling with the idea that your technology, your finance, and you are empowerment because you help a lot of little companies be like big companies.
Yep.
So which are you?
We are all of that.
Okay.
We want to empower companies to make sure that the small companies have all the tools that the big companies have. We started with a simple thing, never miss a sale.
Right.
And today we help you manage your whole business.
And how many, what total addressable market and how many customers could there be?
So we look at it in the US, we think we have about a $26 billion adjusted revenue opportunity. This year we'll get close to about $1 billion. So we're only about 4% penetrated.
Okay.
And that's just the US. We look at same struggles for small businesses globally. So about an 8x opportunity when you start taking it outside the US.
Okay, now we see small business, really small merchants, they go to flea market and they have it.
Yep.
But for a restaurant, you've got a device too that can do more?
So we really try to span the whole continuum. Mm-hmm. We don't really see ourselves running out of room. Like, how big a business could use Square? You're right, it often starts small.
Mm-hmm.
Farmers Market is a great example. But then you start looking at some of the new hardware that we've just launched, which we
okay.
love.
Right.
This is great for a larger seller, someone who maybe has multiple registers sitting on a countertop, a bar like Bar San Miguel.
Okay.
All the way up to, with our API platform, we now can work with really big merchants who want to do something innovative at the point of sale.
Oh, okay.
So we see folks like Restoration Hardware, Williams-Sonoma,
really?
Doing,
okay.
They're ultimately doing warehouse sales. So pop-ups over a weekend would be a great example of, it's not their full-time point of sale, but it helps them be innovative and creative to make more sales.
Excellent. Now, when I saw I saw Jack Dorsey when he came to the floor of the exchange, mm-hmm. and the first thing I said to him was like, "Isn't Visa going to put you out of business?" And he said, "Common mistake. We work with Visa.
Right.
You
yeah.
work with everyone."
Yeah, Visa was actually an early investor in Square.
Right.
Yes, we do. I think people get mixed up between what is a payment type. So we think of cash, checks. Any form of digital motion, debit mm-hmm. cards, credit cards, all the way up into potentially virtual currency, those are all ways that a buyer wants to pay for what they're taking from the seller. So we work with Visa, we work with Amex, we work with MasterCard, we work with Apple Pay, Android Pay. Right. Whatever way I, as the buyer, want to make the sale happen or pay for the good, mm-hmm. we want to make sure the seller can always make that sale.
Right, well, Sarah, you just brought up virtual currency. I was looking at Credit Suisse piece this morning. Bitcoin buying option could help stock. It's talking about a tech crunch story. First, is the story true? And second, you are from Goldman Sachs. Mary Meeker's on your board, maybe the great technology guru from Morgan when she was at Morgan. And David Vinier, okay, now he was the former CFO of Goldman. Bitcoin? Really?
So we're a payment innovator, and
right.
therefore I think it behooves us to always know where are payments going.
Okay.
And one thing I will tell you now, working within a company, so no longer kind of sitting on the other side watching, is you just don't do academic papers at companies. You have no time.
Right.
And so the only way to get people invested in figuring out what is the what about something new is to actually create a product and actually get it out there. When we develop products at Square, we spend a lot of time listening to what
right.
our customers want. And what we heard from individuals, so this isn't sellers asking to accept Bitcoin. This is individuals using Square Cash to
okay.
make payments.
You better explain Square Cash to people because
yeah.
you know,
okay.
that just sounds like a different kind of cash, but go ahead.
I'll come through with Square Cash.
All right,
but Square Cash, individuals saying, we want an easy way to buy and sell Bitcoin, right? You're talking about it. It's out there. Right. And so we want to do an experiment and say, okay, is this real? Do customers actually want to be able to do this? And then what it does internally is it makes everyone who supports that sort of innovation get to work and figure out, how do we do this and do this in the right way?
Now, Jamie Dimon famously said that it could be a fraud. Lloyd Blankfein of Goldman Sachs is kind of questioning about it. Now, but your customers are demanding it, so it really doesn't matter whether someone thinks it's a fraud. If your customer wants it, you're going to be there helping.
I think ultimately you have to be out there taking some risk and being able to go where innovation is going. To kind of decide up front that something, you shouldn't do it. I mean, it feels like the early days of the internet or the early days of the shift to the cloud, right? How many people said, we'll never take data outside our data center,
right?
That's not safe. And then look at what, you know, my old boss, Mark Benioff, has done, for example. I know you know him well. So I look at digital currency like that. I don't think we know yet what it's going to be, but I think it absolutely, as an innovator, Square has to be there to let a customer do what they want to do.
Well, we should talk about the innovation because, for instance, you have a call on my register if you want it. So you actually know the cash flows. I was initially very suspect about the idea that you'd be making these loans to small business, but you actually know more about the cash than any other provider.
That's exactly right. So when we looked at a product like Square Capital, mm-hmm. we said, is there a need? It goes back to what our customers want.
Right.
And we know that small businesses don't get access to capital.
Right.
We're offering loan sizes of $6,000, $7,000, right? A bank can't do that. It's way too cost prohibitive. What's our competitive advantage? We have access to data. So the mm-hmm. signal we get from payments is not like anything else. We have an install base of customers that know us and trust us.
Right.
And we have a way to offer the product where it matches their working capital. So when business is good, they pay back more. When business is bad, they pay back less. And they love it. So again, we're able to do it with loan loss rates that have been, you know, approximately 4%. So when you think about who we're lending to, that's an amazing outcome.
Yes, it is, because those are allegedly the most dangerous people to lend. Now, you mentioned Mark Benioff. And we know that these people are vested, so they're not going to. But one of the things that Mark has taught us is that if you can have access to big data and can analyze it, you can make much better decisions.
Yeah.
So have you been able, if someone takes this, can I get the data?
So where you do get access to data as a seller, sitting in your seat, is your customer data, which everyone knows is the most important thing, right? After I get access to capital to start and grow my business, I need access to customers so I can sell them more or sell to new customers. And what Square has built is an amazing ecosystem. We have 90 million unique customer IDs here in the United States. When I take my first receipt on Square, thereafter, every time I show up at a Square merchant, effectively that merchant can now contact Sarah. And we do that using the card. It's kind of an amazing superpower for a small business. With that, they're able to put up marketing campaigns. We know that every dollar they spend, they make about $10 incremental sales. We know that about they see about a 70% lift in return customers when they use a marketing campaign off of Square. So that's how they get access to the data.
Okay, one last question. When you mention Bitcoin, I mean, for instance, Jensen Huang at NVIDIA, he actually, they use the NVIDIA chips to mine Bitcoin. And he basically had to say, listen, walk it back a little. That can't be the narrative of my company. Are you not afraid that Bitcoin will be the narrative of Square? It's such a powerful and loved, look, you're from the business. You know how exciting it is to people. Is that what we're going to be thinking of Square as, a Bitcoin company?
No, the narrative of our company will be economic empowerment. It's what gets us excited and up in the morning. We've gotten small businesses onto a platform to accept digital payments in a way they were never allowed to do.
Right.
Similarly, in a product like Square Cash, we're getting the underbanked up and onto a platform, getting them access to an account that gets them able to make payments online, make payments offline, and to be able to make use of Bitcoin if they want to.
Wow. This is a powerful story. I thought after we caught a triple, it might be done. I think I'm wrong. That's Sarah Friar, CFO of Square, with a very powerful story and Bitcoin thrown in. Stick with Cramer.
Thanks.
Booyah! Jim Cramer here from Mad Money. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube. Click here to subscribe and get the jump on my exclusives with CEOs, plus market news, investing advice, and a whole lot more.